Hello students, welcome to session on discussion of numerical ability. IBPS clerk prelim mock test. Mock test reference number AIMT 2012002. Now, before we start discussing the questions, let us look at the strategy to be implemented for this particular paper. Now, there is a section wise time limit of 20 minutes, so 35 questions in a numerical ability. The time limit is given is 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, you need to solve this particular section. Now, if you look at this particular paper, this particular AIMT, you have questions on simplifications. Then you have questions on wrong number series. Then you have questions on individual quant questions, arithmetic questions, equations, ratio, time and work, time and distance, so on, arithmetic questions. And you have data interpretation questions. You have two sets of data interpretation. Two sets. Right? Now, if you see here, the order to be followed, as we have discussed in an earlier papers also, start with simplification. There were 10 questions on simplifications. You start with simplifications, then 5 questions on wrong number series, you attempt that. Then you solve individual questions. Those are your arithmetic questions, individual questions, equations, ratio, time and work, time, speed and distance. You solve those questions. Then do your data interpretation. I told you two sets, each containing 5 questions, stable 5 questions and caselets, data given in the form of what you call table, line graph, bar graph, you have 5 questions. Now, this 35 questions you need to attempt in 20 minutes of time. Now, if you look at this particular mock test, let us see, if you start with simplification, these 20 minutes, how we are going to divide. You spend some 4 minutes, because it's only simplifications, you can solve them fastly, 4 minutes of time and simplifications, you can score 6 to 7 questions. You can answer 6 to 7 questions. Then spend 3 minutes of time on your wrong number series. You can attempt about 3 to 4 questions. Then arithmetic questions, individual questions. You spend some 5 minutes of time because there are only 10 questions. You can easily attempt 6 to 7 questions. Then spend 8 minutes of time on data interpretation. In this 8 minutes of time, what you can do is you can score somewhere around 6 to 8 marks or 6 to 7 questions you can attempt in this 8 minutes of time. So spend 4 minutes on table, 4 minutes on caselet. Let us say if you are not comfortable, generally we say that leave caselet in the exam. You are not comfortable with caselet, then I am saying those 4 minutes you can distribute either if any questions are left over in individual questions or simplifications. You can use that time to solve those questions if you feel that caselet is difficult and you are not able to attempt in the given 4 minutes of time. These 4 minutes on table, the remaining 4 minutes which you spend on caselet can be used for simplifications. You can spend that 4 minutes on individual questions or series where you can answer few more questions, right? Now, if you see here, 18 plus 3, 21 plus 4, 25. These are minimum number of attempts or minimum number of questions you can get correct in the examination within 20 minutes of time. I am saying you can attempt more than this. It's you're always welcome, but anything less than this range, whatever I have given, I am saying then you need to seriously analyze where you are actually going wrong. Maybe understanding the question or the concept or whatever it might be, you need to put that effort and you need to definitely increase your score. Right, students. Let us look at directions for question numbers 1 to 10. Now, we have what will come in place of the question mark in the following question. So, the first 10 questions are based on simplifications. So, x percentage of 200 plus under root 225 is equal to 256 divided by 4 plus 9. You remember Bodmer's rule. What is Bodmer's rule? Brackets of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. We need to simplify. The order of preference of the operators should be in this order. First, you will simplify the numbers inside brackets, then of symbol, that is multiplication, division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Now, 4 goes 64 times. 64 plus 9 is 73 is equal to root 225. Root 225 is nothing but 15. plus 2x. So I can say 2x is equal to 58, 73 minus 15. From this I can say x is equal to 29. 29 is present in third option, right? Because this is, question mark is x I am taking. X percent means x by 100 into 200. So it will be 2x. Root 225 is 15. 64 plus 9 is 73. So 2x is equal to 58. X is equal to 29. Present in third option. Question number 2. 6 into 18 into 9 divided by 4 minus x square is equal to 143. Question mark is nothing but I am taking as x square. So friends, see here, x square is equal to 6 into 18 into 9 by 4 minus 143. This plus 143 goes to that side, it's minus 143, right? So here, 2 twos, 2 nines, 2 goes 3 times. 9 square 81, 81 threes are 243. 243 minus 143, x square is equal to 100. From this we can say root 100 is nothing but x value is 10, present in fourth option. Third question. All these are simple questions, students. X into 12 is equal to 403 minus, how much is this? 14 square is, we can do one thing, right? We can take minus common. So this will be 403 minus 14 square is 196 plus 3 cube is 23. 3 cube is 27, right? 196 plus 27, it is nothing but 223. 403 minus 223. So x into 12 is equal to how much? 180. 12 goes 15 times in 180. X value is 15. It is present in second option. So 27 square minus x cube is equal to 6 cube plus 170. So how much is 6 cube, students? 6 cube is nothing but 216. So here we can add 27 square. How much is 27 square? 729 minus x cube is equal to 216 plus 170. So how much is this? How much? 386. So how much is x cube? 729 minus 386. So 86 plus how much is 29? Two digit addition we know, right? 14 plus 29, 43. We will get 143. So 4 plus how much is 7? 3. So x cube is equal to 343. We know that 343 is 7 cube. So x is equal to 7, present in first option. Right? 27 square, all of you know, it is 729. Or if you don't know also, 27 square, we take the base as 50 square, 2500, right? So 27 is how much less than 50? 23 less. 25 minus 23 is 200 plus 23 less, we will write 23 square, 529. 529 plus 200, 729. We have discussed this in our square, students. Question number 5. Cube root of 512. Cube root of 512 plus 62 by 5 divided by question mark, that is x, is equal to root 72 into 8. Just here, cube root of 512. Cube root of 512 is 8 plus this is 32 by 5x is equal to 24, right? So this root 72 into 8, if you see here, root 72 is 9 into 8 into 8. So 2 8s will get 1 8. For root of 9 is 3. 3 into 8, it will be 24. Cube root of 512 is 8. 30 plus 2, 32 by 5 divided by x. Nothing but 32 by 5x. So 32 by 5x is equal to 24 minus 8 is 16. 16 goes 2 times. So x value is 2 by 5. 2 by 5 is nothing but 0.4, present in fourth option. Question number 6, students. X into 7 by 13 is equal to cube root of 343. We know that 7 into root 225 is 15. So 7 will get cancelled. X is equal to 15 into 13. It is nothing but 195. Present in fifth option. Now look at this. 6384 divided by x divided by 16 is equal to 19. This is nothing but 19 into 16. Right? So 6384 by x, 6384 by x question mark by 16 is equal to 19. So it will be 1 by 16. 16 goes this side, it is 19 into 16. Now 16 3 is 48. 158, 16 9s, 144, again 144, 16 9s. 19 2s, 38, 19, 19 1s, 19. So x is equal to 21. 21 is present in third option. 8th question, 169 plus 101 divided by 9 plus x square is equal to 94. So what is the rule here? Boardman's rule, right? So brackets you have to simplify first. 169 plus 100 270, then you have to do division by 9 plus x square is equal to 94. 9 goes 30 times. So x square is equal to 94 minus 30, 64. From this I can say x is equal to 8. X is equal to 8 is present in choice 2. Ninth question, 40% of 2 by 5 of 1750 is equal to 130 plus x. We need to find out x value. Now see, how much is 2 by 5 of means into? 2 by 5 into 1750 of means into, right? 1750 double, 2 into 1750 means double, 3500. 1700 double 34, 50 double 100, 3500 by 5. So it will be 700. Then what is left here? 40%. So the 40% of 700. 10% of 700 is 70. You have to put a point after one digit. 20% double, 140. 40% again double of this is 280. So this complete value is 280 is equal to 130 plus x. From this I can say x is equal to 280 minus 130. It is 150 present in fifth option. Alright. So I am calculating 2 by 5 of 1750. We are getting 700. Again 40% of that. 40% of 700, 10% 70, double that 20% 140, again double that 40% 280. 280 minus 130 is 150, or we can also write like this. Yeah? The other way of solving is 40% is equal to how much students? The fraction value 2 by 5. So 2 by 5 into 2 by 5 into 1750 is equal to 130 plus 6. Right? So 25, 5 5 is 25, 25 sevens is 175. So how, what will happen? 4 into 70, 280 is equal to 130 plus x. I can say x is equal to 150. You can also solve like this. We can write 40% if you remember it is 2 by 5. You can write it as 2 by 5 and solve. 10th question, the last question in simplifications. 27 cube into 27 cube is equal to 3 power x into 3 power 10. See, 27 is nothing but 3 cube. So 27 cube is nothing but 3 cube whole power 3. So, a power m whole power n is nothing but a power m into n. So, 3 power 3 into 3 is 9. So, this will be 3 power 9 into 3 power 9 is equal to 3 power x into 3 power 10. One second. Right? So, a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. When base is same, we'll add the power. So 3 power 18 by, this is how much? 10 plus 6, 3 power 16 is equal to 3 power x. So this goes 3 square times. So x is equal to, bases are equal, we'll make the powers equal. X is equal to 2. X is equal to 2 is present in first option. Question number 11 to 15 are based on finding out the wrong number series. We are not discussing this here. Solutions are also, questions are also easy. You can look at the solutions to understand if you have any doubt in that, students, right? So we'll move to our next set. Question number 16 to 25. Select the correct alternative from the given choices. These are your individual quant questions. So these are your arithmetic questions, right? So let us spend some time on solving these questions. Question number 16, students. This question, okay, I can say can be classified as easy. Every question, I'll tell you, individual questions, what is the level of difficulty of the question. Simplifications, you can see almost all questions, about 6 to 7 questions are easy, maybe 2-3 questions involve little calculations. Let us look at this. This is an easy question. This is a standard time and work model, right? 15 men can do a work in 12 days, 12 women can do the same work in 30 days. So, we can write, men's efficiency, I'm taking it as M unit. So, 15M into 12 days is equal to 12 women efficiency, W units, let us say they do, into 30 days. I am equating these two because they are doing the same work. So, total work should be always same. 15 into men efficiency M, they are completing in 12 days. Same work, 12 women efficiency, let us say W units, they are completing in 30 days. Now, 12 will get cancelled, 15 goes 2 times. Now, question is straightforward. What is the relation? M is equal to 2 W. Right? Now, see, find the number of days taken by 6 men and 8 women to complete the work. Now, whenever equation contains more than one variable, convert this equation completely into one variable. 6 into men plus, we can substitute 2 women plus 8 women. 6 into 2, 12, 12 plus 8 is 20 women. So 6 men plus 8 women is nothing but 20 women. Now my question is straightforward. 12 women takes 30 days. 20 women will take how many days? What's the formula? M1 D1 is equal to M2 D2. 12 women are taking 30 days. 20 women will take how many days? 0, 0 will get cancelled. 2 goes 6 times. D2 is equal to 18. 18 is present in choice 2. This question is based on a simple concept of time at work, variation concept and M1 D1 formula. You can classify this question as easy. Question number 17, students. This question actually is a combination of your averages and equations, right? Now, I am saying this question can also be classified as easy if you remember a simple average point. Now, see it. What's the question? 4 years ago, the ratio of ages of M and N was 6 is to 5. If M is 4 years older than N, find the average of present ages of M and N. M is 4 years older than N. That means the difference between age of M and N is 4 years. So the present difference is 4 years. Now, what will be the difference 1 year ago? 4 years. 5 years ago, 4 years. After 1 year, 4 years. After 10 years, 4 years. I'll give an example. See here. Let us say my age and I'll take your age. Let's say my age is 40 years and let's say your age is, let's say, I'm not saying 25, but I'm taking some decent number, right? 40 minus 25, our present difference is 15 years. What's the difference last year? Last year, my age would have been 39, 1 year less. Your age would have been 24. Difference is how much? 15. What's the difference 5 years ago? 5 years ago, I'm 35, you'll be 20. Difference is 15 years. What's the difference next year? Next year, I will be 45, you will be 26. Don't always increase the age of your faculty. Your age will also increase, right? So next year, I will be 41, you will be 26, right? So what's the difference? Difference will be 15. Okay. If I ask you after 5 years, I will be 45, you will be 30. The difference is 15. This is a very crucial point, right? You might have learned this in your simple equations class. If the difference between ages of two persons is X years, now 1 year ago, 2 years ago, 10 years ago, K years ago, 1 year after, 2 years after, K years after, the difference will be always X years. Now from the question, you can see here, the difference between M's age and N's age is 4 years. Now if it is 4 years, 4 years ago also, the difference will be 4 years. 4 years ago, what are the ages of M and N? 4 years ago, M is equal to 6K, N is equal to 5K because it is ratio. Right, so difference 6K minus 5K is equal to 4. Now 4 means any given time it will be 4 years only. So K is equal to 4. K is equal to 4 means what is M's age 4 years ago? 24. What is N's age? 20. Right. Now what is the question? Find the average of the present ages. So it is 4 years ago age. Present age means M will be 28, N will be 24. Average means by 2. So 52 by 2, it will be 26 years. 26 years is present in third option. Right? So the difference here is 4 years. Present difference 4 years means any given time it will be 4 years only. So 6k minus 5k is 4. From this I'll get k is equal to 4. K is equal to 4 means M's age is 24, N's age is 20. When? 4 years ago. We want present average. So each one will increase by 4. Right? So 44, if you take 4 years ago. Now what will happen? 8 years, if you see here, 44, right? 4 years ago. Now present means each one will increase by 4, we'll add 8. So 52, average means by 2, I can say 26. I can also solve like this. Right? Let us take up next question, 18th question. So this question is based on boats and ships. This question is based on subtropical boats and streams under time and distance. But this question can be classified as easy. If you know the concept of boats and streams, this is easy. Time taken by a boat to travel 18 kilometers downstream is 2.5 hours. 2.5. Nothing but 5 by 2 hours. And time taken to travel 12 kilometers upstream is 3 hours. 5. The speed of the boat in still water. Okay. Let us write down. Speed of the boat in still water let's say take it as B, and speed of the stream or water. Or stream, let us take it as W. So what is my upstream speed? How will you get your upstream speed? Upstream speed is given by, what do you mean by upstream? Water flowing in this direction, he'll be moving in the opposite direction, right? So speed of the water will resist the boat. So what is your upstream speed? B minus W. Downstream speed, B plus W. What do you mean by downstream? Water is flowing in this direction, your boat also moving the same direction. Speed of the water will push the boat. As a result, speed of the boat will increase. So downstream speed is how much? B plus W. Now see here, boat is covering or traveling 18 kilometers downstream in 2.5 hours. So downstream speed, B plus W. What is speed formula? Speed is equal to distance by time. So downstream speed is B plus W, distance 18 kilometers in 2.5 hours, 5/2 hours. So 36 by 5, 7.2 kilometers per hour, right? Then it is traveling 12 kilometers upstream in 3 hours. So upstream speed, B minus W, speed is distance by time. It is going 12 kilometers in 3 hours. 12 by 3 is 4, 4 kilometers per hour. Now it is simple. How much is my B minus W? 7.2. How much is B plus W? 4. What is that we need? We need B value. Add these two. 2B is equal to 11.2. 2, 5, 10, 2, 6, 12. 5.6 kilometers per hour. It is present in choice 4. So, it is a question based on boats and stream concept. Simple question, students. Let us take up 19th question. Trader marked the price of an article as rupees 1080. This is your market price. Offered a discount of rupees 180. This is your discount amount. Had the discount not been given. What do you mean by discount not being given? What do you mean by discount not being given? If I am not giving any discount, that means I am selling at my market price. Discount not being given means your selling price will be equal to your market price. Generally what happens, an article will be marked at certain price. So when you went to purchase that article, they will give certain discount. So from your market price, we will subtract that discount. Whatever discount we are subtracting, whatever amount we are paying, that amount is nothing but my selling price. Now, when I am saying I am not offering any discount, so if you are not giving any discount, your market price must be equal to your selling price. That is what the meaning, right? So, had the discount not been given, means if he is selling at market price itself, then what is happening? The trader is getting or gaining or making a profit of 25%. Find the actual profit earned on the article, okay? Okay, because profit and loss, and most of you are not comfortable with profit and loss, I am saying it is somewhere between easy and moderate. Between, it's not easy, it's not moderate, it is lies between somewhere between easy to moderate. If you know the concept, it is easy, students. Now, see here. Let us start with this. He is not giving the discount. If the discount is not given, means selling price is equal to market price. That means he is selling at what price? 1080. Then he is making a profit of how much percent? 25%. 25% profit means what is my selling price? 125%. 125% is 1080. My cost price should be 100%. How much? Is this point clear, students? I am selling at a profit of 25%. Cost price will be always 100%. Right? The base is always 100. So cost price will take it as 100. I am selling at 25% profit. That means my selling price should be 100 plus 25, 125%. 30% profit, 100 plus 30, 130%. 10% profit, 100 plus 10, I am selling at 110% of the cost price. Or if I am selling at 10% loss, 100 minus 10, I am selling at 90% of the cost price. 20% less, 100 minus 20, 80%. If I am selling at 25% loss, 100 loss, so I am subtracting minus 25, 75%. So 125%. Easy selling price 1080, cost price 100%. How much? So cost price is 100 into 1080 by 125. 25 fours, 25 fives. 5 twos, 10, 5 ones, 5, 5 6. So 864. 4 into 216. 200 into 4 is 800. 16 into 4 is 64. 864 is the cost price. Now, if he is giving a discount of 180 rupees, right? So market price 1080, he is giving a discount of, I am taking the first case, 180 rupees. So discount of 180 rupees means market price minus discount is my selling price. He is selling at 900 rupees. Now article 864, he is selling at 900. 900 minus 864, he is gaining or making a profit of how many rupees? 36 rupees. 36 rupees is present in choice. Fine. Question number 30. This is based on simple interest and compound interest. Again, whenever it is profit loss, simple interest, compound interest, it demands certain calculations are involved, demands certain time. So again, I am putting this bit somewhere between easy to moderate. I am not saying moderate, at the same time not saying easy. You can place it somewhere between easy to moderate. Now see, a man is investing 50,000 in two schemes for 3 years. So he's investing in two different schemes. Scheme 1, scheme 2. Right? In both the schemes, he is investing for same time period. Alright? 3 years. Here also is investing for 3 years. Okay. The first scheme offers simple interest. Okay. It is under simple interest at the rate of 12% per annum. The second one, compound interest, compounded annually at the rate of 10% per annum. This is compounded annually, right? Difference between interest and from these two schemes. Now, don't apply formula I is equal to PTR by 100. There is no direct formula to find interest under compound interest. You have to find out amount. A into A is nothing but P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power T. R, if I want interest, so what will happen? Subtract what you call principal. So P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power T. Don't make it complicated. Let us make it easy, right? Let us not use the formula. Let us see how we solve this particular question. Right. Now, 1 year 12%, 2 years, I'm talking about scheme one, simple interest. 2 years, what is the rate of interest? 12 plus 12, 24. 3 years means rate of interest I'll get here is 36%. What about compound interest? I'll take for 2 years, 10%, first year, 10%, second year, 10%, third year. If I take 2 years, I can apply my net change formula, x plus y plus xy by 100%. What is the net change for 2 years? 21%. You remember, what is the net change formula? X plus Y plus XY by 100%. Right? If it is for 2 years, compound interest, we can apply this formula. X plus Y plus XY by 100%. Successive percentage formula. Now, while discussing successive percentages, you might have come across this. If there are 2 successive percentages, I can use this formula. What happens if I have 3 successive percentages? Still, you can use this formula, but you have to apply this formula how many times? 2 times. Now, for these 2 years, first 2 years, 10%, 20% coming to 21%. And for third year, again 10%. So, 21 plus 10, again apply the formula. 21 into 10 by 100. 0, 0, this is 2.1, 33.1%. This is the interest I am getting. You got the point? 10%, 10%, 10% compound interest. For 2 years, compound interest, net rate of interest can be found out by using the formula x plus y plus xy by 100%. Successive percentage formula. I am applying, I am getting 21. 21% and again, how much is left out? 10%. So 21 plus 10, again apply the formula. If there are 3 successive percentages, you have to apply the formula 2 times. So different in the interest earned. So I am saying, what is the difference in interest rate? 36%, 33.1%. The difference is 2.9%. Right? Don't calculate 2.9% of what is the total investment? 50,000, right? In each of these two schemes. So it is 2.9% of 50,000. Now I am saying, I am asking a simple question. How much is 1%? 500. 1% you have to put a point after 2 digits, right? So how much is 3%? 1500. Difference we are getting is 2.9. So it is less than, slightly less than 3%. My answer should be slightly less than 1500. Less than 1500, if you can see, how many options are present? Only one option. That should be. That should be your answer. No need to simplify, not required. Otherwise, you calculate 2.9%, 2.9 by 100 into 50,000, you simplify, cancel, you'll get the answer. I'm saying, I'm roughly calculating 3%, 1500. Less than 3%, means answer should be less than 1500. There is only one option, less than 1500. That should be your answer, right? Question number 21, students. Now, again, this is based on your successive percentage formula. This is based on successive percentages. Now, we can classify this question as easy. Because it is based on your, just now we have discussed that formula, right? X plus Y plus XY by 100. In 2019, the number of persons who like sweets in the town is 20,000. If the number of persons who like sweets decreases at the rate of 20% per year, what was the number of persons who like sweets in 2017? Right? 2019, number of persons who like sweets are 20,000. Right? Now, what is the number of persons who like sweet in 2017? How many persons like sweets? What happened? If the number of persons who like sweets decreases at the rate of 20% per year. So 2017 to 2018, 20% number of persons decreased. 2018 to 2019, number of persons again decreased by 20%. I can use my net change formula x plus y plus xy by 100%. Two successive percentages, right? Decrease means we'll use minus 20 plus minus 20 plus minus 20 into minus 20 by 100. So minus 20 minus 20 is minus 40 plus 4, minus 36%, or we can say minus sign indicates 36% decreased. So 2017, 2019, I'll say instead of giving two times decrease, I can say in single, if you look at net change, it's 36% decrease. If it is 100 in 2017, 2019, it should be 100 minus 36, 64. Now students, here, this 2019 value, we know 64 is 20,000. Find in 2017, 100 is how much? 100 into 20,000 by 64. Right? 16 fours, 16 1 60, 40 16 2 30, 80, 16 5s. Again, 4 3 is 12, 4 1s 4, 10, 4 2s 8. 312.5 into 100, 31,250. It is present in fifth option. You got the point. 20% decrease, again 20% decrease. So 20 minus 20 minus 20 decrease. So plus minus 20 into minus 20 by 100, minus 36%. That means overall 36% decrease. 2017, if you take it as 100, 2019 it is 64. So 2019 value, 64 is given as 20,000. 100 is how much? Right? Question number 22, students. A man spent 60% of his monthly salary towards paying the monthly bills. So this question is based on the concept of percentages. I can say this question can be classified as easy. It's based on your basic fundamental concept. So man is spending 60% of his monthly salary towards paying the monthly bills, and he's saving the remaining. Out of his savings, he gave 15%, whatever is left over out of the savings, he gave 15% to the first son, 20% to the second son, 25% to the first daughter, and the remaining to his second daughter. If the amount received by second daughter is 4,800, find the amount spent towards monthly bills. It is simple, students. Monthly bills, how much is he spending? 60%. He's spending monthly bills 60%. What are his savings? Total income will be 100, right? Monthly bills 60%. His savings are 40%. Out of this 40%, he is giving to four people. Who are those? First son. First son. He is giving certain part to second son. Then he is giving to first daughter. And the remaining to his second daughter. Right? So, his savings are 40%. Out of 40%, he gave 15%. Out of his savings, whatever is, so he's not giving 15% from the income, whatever is left over, out of that 15% is giving to his savings. So see, please understand, it is not 15%, it is 6% is giving to his first son. 15% out of the savings. So 40% of my savings, what is my 10% of 44? 5%, 2. 15% is 10% plus 5%. Out of 40, 10% is 4, 5% will be 2, 4 plus 2, 6. 20% is giving to second son, 10% 4, 20% is 8%. 25% to the first daughter, 25% is 1/4, 1/4 of 40 is 10%. So 10, 18 plus 6, 24% is given to 3, 40 minus 24, 16% is given to his second daughter. So simple, 16% value is 4800. He is asking you, what is the amount spent on monthly bill? 60%. 16 into, if you observe here, 16 into, 16 goes how many times? 3 times in 48, 300, right? So 60 should be multiplied by 300. So 18 followed by 3 zeros, it should be 18,000. 18,000 is present in second option. Question number 23, student. This is a simple question based on basic concept of time, speed and distance. Time, speed and distance. Right, we can classify this question as easy. We can classify this question as easy. Right, now read the question, students. A car covers certain distance in 90 minutes traveling at a speed of 80 kilometers per hour. Right? Distance formula, speed into time. So 80 kilometers per hour is covering in 90 minutes. Right? So distance, see, actually you have to convert, you have to write it in hours, or you have to, I can say 3.5, or you convert these kilometers per hour into meters per second. Let us not do that because answer is in minutes only. Let us write it as 80 into 90, total distance. If you travel the same distance at 100 kilometers, find the difference in time taken. Time is equal to distance by speed. What is my distance? 80 into 90 is traveling at 100 kilometers per hour. So how many minutes is taking? 72 minutes. Earlier is taking 90 minutes, now is taking 72 minutes. Difference, time taken by the car in traveling, these two difference, right? So difference in time taken, right? What's the difference? 90 minutes earlier, now 72 minutes. The difference in time taken is 18 minutes. 18 minutes is nothing but third option. Question number 24. The ratio of length to breadth of a rectangle is 7:3. If the perimeter of the rectangle is 300 meters, find the area of the rectangle. Question simple. What is my length, students? Length is 7k, my breadth is 3k. Perimeter is given by 2 into L plus B. This is given as how much? 300. So 2 into, how much is L plus B? 7 plus 3, 10k is equal to 300. So what is my k value? 15. Right? What is the question? Find the area of the rectangle. Area of the rectangle is given by length into breadth. So 7k into 3k is nothing but 21k square. So 21, k value, you know, 15 into 15. 15 square, 225. 225 into 20. 225 double. 225 into 20. I'll write 21 as 20 plus 1. 225 into 20. Double of 225. 450. So 4500 plus another 225. So 4725. 4725 is present in fifth option. Question number 25, students. We have discussed whether it is an easy question. This question can be classified as easy. See how many easy questions are there. Again, question number 25. This question is based on mixtures and allegation. Averages, mixtures, allegation topic. So basically, it is based on mixtures topic. And we can classify this question as easy. Now see here. Total solution, we have 75 liters. What is the total solution we have? We have a solution of milk and water, 75 liters, right? In this milk is to water, the ratio is 7:8. So how much will be milk, right? 35 liters. How much will be water? 40 liters. You can add 7 by 15 into 75, 15 goes 5 times. So 7 into 5, 35, 8 into 5, 40. Or 15 part 75 means each part 5, 35 and 40. When 15 liters of water is added, I am adding again 15 liters of water. So, what will be my total water now? 55 liters. What is the question? Find the ratio of milk and water. Milk is same, no change. Water is 55. 5 sevens, 5 elevens. 7:11. 7:11 is present in fourth option. So, this is also an easy question, students. Now, directions, we have completed our individual questions. Individual questions here, how many are easy? 25 is easy. 24 is easy. 23 is easy. Like that you count, you can easily get about 7 to 8 easy questions, students. Directions for 26 to 30, it is based on your data interpretation. I told you that in interpretation we have two sets, right? One set on table and another set on what you call caselet. So study the following table and answer the question that follows. So these five questions are based on tabular data. Now see here, look at the table. The table shows the number of coconuts sold by four sellers A, B, C, D from Monday to Friday in a week. So Monday to Friday, A, B, C, D are the four sellers. So he has given number of coconuts sold by these four sellers. Few questions based on this, right? So question number 26. Average number of coconuts sold by D per day. What is D total? Average is sum of all quantities by total number of quantities, right? 128, 200. 70, 50, 120, 80, 200, add these two, 160. So, total is 360 of D. So, 360 upon average means 1, 2, 3, 5 days, Monday to Friday. It is 72. 72 is present in fifth option. 27th question. What is the ratio of total number of coconuts sold by A on Monday and Tuesday to that sold by D on Thursday and Friday? A, Monday and Tuesday, 85 plus 65, 150. D, on Thursday, Friday, 70 plus 85, 155. 530s, 531s. So what is the ratio? 30 is to 31, present in fourth option. 28. The total number of coconuts sold by C on Thursday and Friday. Total number of coconuts sold by C on Thursday and Friday together. If you see here, Thursday, Friday, coconut, 60 plus 80, 140. Right? Forms what percentage of total number of coconuts sold by C in the given period? C, total number of coconuts sold. So how will you get total number of coconuts sold by C? You have to add this, right? Add these five values. So this is 170, 260, 320, 400 is total C. So Thursday and Friday 140 by total 400 into 100. 4, 3 is a 12, 20, 4, 5 is a 20. So 35%. 35% is present in first option, right? So if you want total number of coconuts sold by a seller, you have to add row wise. If you want total number of coconuts sold by all sellers in a particular day, let's say Monday, what is the total? Day wise total, you have to add column wise. Person wise total, you have to add row wise. Right. Anybody have the doubt, I am explaining that, right? So, a particular seller, what is the total means? Add row wise. In a particular day, what is the total means? You have to add column wise. 29th question. What is the difference between total number of coconuts sold by B on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and total number of coconuts sold by A on Wednesday? That is a simple question. Difference between total number of coconuts sold by B and Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. 80 plus 70, 150 plus 60, 210 minus A on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. 55 plus 40, 95 plus 95, 190. The difference is how much? 20. 20 is present in third option. Question number 30. In the given period, by what percentage is total number of coconuts sold by D more or less than total number of coconuts sold by B? D already we know, it is 360, right? B we need to find out. B total 150, 210, 300, 375. So obviously, clearly D is less than B. Percentage less. Difference 15. Opposite of less is larger value, which is larger value 375 into 100. 15 2 is 30, 75 15 5, 25 goes 4 times. So it is 4% less, it is present in third option. Directions for question number 31 to 35. Study the data given below carefully to answer the questions that follow. So this is basically based on your caselet, right? Three fruit sellers P, Q and R sells apples and bananas. So these are caselet questions. So generally caselets we ask you to leave, don't try. If at all if you complete everything, then only remaining all areas, then you can try. But caselets are generally time consuming. If you make a mistake, then all questions might go wrong, entire data might go wrong. That is why that should be your last preference. But caselets like this, this is an easy set of caselets. These kind of things can be attempted. You can try attempting this in your exam. Three fruit sellers we have. P, Q, R. Okay. And I'll take a total here. This raw data, you have to put it in a form of table. Apple, banana. Because you can't solve this like your reading comprehension questions. I'll take one more total here. Person wise total. Right now let us look at this. In a month, the total number of fruits sold by P is 480. P total is 480. Out of this, banana, apple is to banana by sold by P is 1:3. So apple is to banana is 1:3. So apple will be 1/4 of 480. 120. 120. So obviously the other thing should be 360. Right, 1:3 means 4 parts. 4 parts, 480 means 1 part is 120. So 1 part means 120, 3 parts 360. Yeah, 1:3 means 1/4 into 480. It should be 120. Then the number of apples and bananas sold by Q is 200% and 50% more than those sold by P respectively. Now apples, if we take 200% more, right? So 200% of 120. So 200% means 240. 240 more means 120 plus 240 is 360. So 200% means 200% is 200/100 into 120. So how much is 200% value? 240. 200% more is saying. So 240 more than P. 120 plus 240, 360. 50%. 50% of 360 is nothing but 180. So 180 more than this, right? So 360 plus 180, 540. So this total, if you add, 900. Number of bananas sold by R is 340 more than number of apples sold by him. Let us say apples, we don't know X. Bananas will be X plus 340. 340 more. Right? A total number of fruits sold by PQ and R in this month is 2000. PQ and R sold total 2000. So 1380. So 2000, if I add P and Q, it is 1380. 2000 minus 1380 is 620. So this is nothing but my R. So R, if you want to find out apple and banana, add these two, X plus X, 2X plus 340 is equal to 620. Right? So 2X is equal to 280. X is equal to 140. This is 140. 140 plus 340, it is 480. Now add this, 100 is 180, 9, 10, 13, 80. Add this, 100, 120. So 2, 5, 6, 20. And this row wise total, column wise total should be equal to 2000. Yes, it is equal to 2000. So the given data, the most important thing is you have to slowly, clearly, neatly represent that in the form of a table. Once you write the data in the form of a table, then solving questions is not a big deal. Now, point is, if you make a mistake here in the data here, writing the data, then everything will go wrong. The same thing I have copied here. 120, 360, 480, 360, 540, 900, 140, 480, 620, 620, 1380, 2000. Right. Question number 31, students. What is the difference between maximum number of bananas sold by any one of the sellers, minimum number of apples sold by any one of them in the month? Maximum number of bananas 540. Minimum number of apples is 120. So 540 minus 120. So 20 plus 20 is 40. So difference is 420. Nice number, right? So choice 4. Question number 32. What is the ratio of total number of apples sold by Q and R? Q and R total apples, 360 plus 140. How much? 500 is to banana sold by P and Q, 360 plus 540, 900. So what's the ratio? 5 is to 9. 5 is to 9 is present in first option. Question number 33. Number of bananas sold by P, okay, 360, forms what percentage of total number of fruits sold by Q? Total number of fruits sold by Q is 900. 360 by 900 into 100. So what percentage means? 9 goes exactly 4 times in 36, 40% present in second option. Right? 34th question. Average number of bananas sold by all the three fruit sellers in the month. Average banana is total banana. We know, don't calculate. Already we have total banana. We have done that. 1380 divided by 3 sellers. 3 4s are 12, 3 6s are 18. 460. 460 is present in 5th option. 35. Total number of fruits sold by R in this month. Total number of fruits, no need to calculate, we have 620. I told you, no, questions are easy to solve. Only thing is that you should be able to write the given data in the form of a table. Now, you have seen that there are about 6-7 easy questions in simplification, about 6-7 easy questions in your arithmetic question, then about 3-4 in your series, and DI, these two sets, even though it is a case set, is an easy set. I am saying you can score minimum 6 marks to 8 marks from these two sets. So, I told you that range, right? Anybody getting less than the 21 mark, 21 to 25, I am saying you need to seriously brush up your concept and see what exactly you are doing wrong in the examination, right? So, time management is one thing which is very, very important, students. You need to have a tab on the time. Once the time is completed, you have to stop this, go to the next set, go to the next set, because you need to identify easy questions and solve, and easy questions will be distributed throughout the week. Right? Hope you have followed. Let's stop here. Stay home, stay safe, prepare with time classes. Thank you so much, students.